work relationships are incredibly important in our lives. I think we spend about 80-70%, if not more, 80-90% sometimes of our lives at work, with colleagues, with employees, whether it's online in this current scenario of the world or offline otherwise. And I think what happens is if we don't have social relationships or a space where we can be connected with the people we spend the most time with, it leads to employees and organizations functioning in a very high stress modality. What happens then is our output is impacted, health is impacted, and well-being is impacted. And work can really, really become a very lonely place. One of the things that a lot of social psychologists have researched is that the more we have organizations that develop and hone a space for relationships to flourish, which can include social spaces to have lunch or spend time, or a culture which even from WhatsApp to video calls creates a space where we can celebrate someone's birthday or a landmark year that they've been part of an organization, where we can have friends at work, support systems at work, where people care enough to connect with each other, to check in on each other. Our health, our social health, our physical health, our emotional health are on a high. And when that happens, we're able to work better, we feel more motivated, and more importantly, there's a sense of belonging to the organization, to the space, which makes us feel happy. Happiness is very often undervalued in the workspace, and it's a surprise because it is where we spend most of our time. So to encourage happiness will lead to employees being more motivated, will lead to us being able to understand where someone's not having a good day, and for us to be able to then reach out to care enough to connect with them to see if they're doing okay. This is not just relationships between colleagues. I think it's about relationships between colleagues, about colleagues with their bosses, with subordinates, with, you know, the whole organization, the whole team at large. And I think that is what makes for strong, safe spaces for mental health. We're not only better at what we produce, we're more motivated to find newer outcomes, new ideas, work on newer goals, enhance our own skills, both in the employee space and also personally in our own lives. I think if our well-being is higher, if stress levels are lower, we also do better in terms of physical health, which is less sick days, which is better for the organization in general. So I think if, as individuals, we can make it our prerogative to reach out to our friends, to our employee friends, to our colleagues, to check in on them once in a while, to make sure we reach out, to make sure even in this time, which is only connected via the online world or online spaces, that we have a conversation over that phone or stay an extra 10 minutes on a Zoom call to make sure that we're able to talk about other things in life other than this particular, you know, piece of work that needs to go out or needs to be submitted or this deadline that needs to be met, we feel happier. And happiness is extremely paramount in not just today's world, which is a time which is extremely hard on all of us, but always for our well-being, individually and organizationally. So let's care to connect and let's reach out to each other as much as we possibly can.